All right, so we are back on Fear 3. So, this is on Steam. I'm doing some online co-op. So, Interval 5. Tower is the next one. All right. So, apparently, Jin was kidnapped, so we gotta continue here. So, let's try to make our way past these guys over here. I think I can... Yeah, I can shoot them down. Oh, there's one dude over there, and he's gone. Well, he got messed up. Look at that. You can see his intestines. Disgusting, and it's gruesome. So, I think I also have a new teammate. Yes, I do. We got somebody new. Let's see if this guy is aware of Fettel's special attack during the slow-mo. We'll see. So, I'm still leveling up my character. So I gotta get all these points that are available. There's one psychic link. Alright, yes, I will take that one, and I'll take, yeah, this one. Yeah, so I don't really use the pistol that much, so I'll stick with this burst rifle and the shotgun. Alright, so let's make our way outside to the street area. There's the SMG. I'll skip on that. I'll stick with these two weapons here. Oh, he crouched. Let me get this guy. He crouched. This guy, I hit him twice, I think, and then he crouched. Great. Come on. We got him. The cover system is actually pretty good. And the whole point system, too, for challenges, I kind of like it. Although once you reach the max rank of 21 for your character, like, there's no point to even like bother with the challenges anymore. So it's like, you know, there's no point. So yeah. Let me go up here first, see if there's any ammunition I can pick up for my... Oh, there's some grenades. I'll take those. Working on the Gatherer challenge. 15 ammo and grenade pickups. There's one dude over here, and there's one over here. Let me try to do a slide attack! And then get him with the... Whoa! I missed! Wow. I did like a double kick. That was cool. I know there's an Alma doll in one of these corners somewhere. I just kind of forgot where it was. I think it was there or not. I don't know. Whoa! Jolly! Look at that. He got massacred. He's just like a red stain on the street now. Damn. Nice. So, let's go this way here. Waiting for the player. I really like the co-op aspect of this game. It's fun. Like, I was playing Fear 1 and Fear 2 offline for just a little bit. And I was thinking, man, these games would be so fun to play in co-op. And then finally, Fear 3 does it. Although, it doesn't feel like Fear 1 or Fear 2 that much. But, you know, it's kind of like its own game. It just, like, plays different in some sense, but it still has that aspect of having slow-mo. I kind of miss Point Man's original costume, also. They should have had that costume in for, like, maybe a pre-order DLC or something. That would have been cool. Oh, let me check... down over here first. Nothing but a pistol. Okay, I will not take that. And anything? I know sometimes there could be a body over there. And the Alma doll can sometimes spawn right down here in the corner. There you are. Can be that. I'm gonna take those points. Let's see. Okay, we got this freak over here. He's a freak of nature. I actually tried the multiplayer version called Fear Combat. I think I tried it maybe 8 or 10 months ago, or maybe a year, I don't know. A long time ago. I don't think I actually recorded any footage of it, but I tried it and I was kind of annoyed by it. They had all these, like, there was, I think, one server that was running a multiplayer team deathmatch, and they were running all these weird looking mods, so, like, everyone didn't even look like a character from the Fear games. Like, it played like Fear, like, with the jump kicks, the slides and stuff like that, and the roundhouse. However, All the models looked like something out of Crysis, like the nano suits. So it was just like a skin or a model change on the multiplayer server, but it was kind of different. But yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna. Whoa, my health, my health, my health. He took a lot of shots, damn. So yeah, the issue with Fear Combat is that, well, for one, it's not that populated online, so yeah, not a lot of people play it. I mean, more than Fear 1 or Fear 2. I mean, no one plays those games, anyways. But I kind of miss the old slow-mo team deathmatch or slow-mo deathmatch game mode. I blew off his arm, and then he did a backflip. Wow. 8 out of 10 for that. That was cool. I'll take this one here. Fatal can actually take over the bodies of the phase commanders and the phase casters. I know at the end of this level we fight a phase or a commander. Well, I think more than one, maybe two or three. So if he gets a chance, he could take control of his body, which is really cool. And he has the penetrator weapon. I forgot what they called it in this game. It looked really cool in the first game too. Oh, there's a sniper here. I see the laser. Slow-mo. Yeah, I see your laser. Where are you? And let me see. There you are. That is so cool. Ooh, I busted his head. Nice. I haven't had a chance to play AVP, I think, since the last video. Maybe it was what, 6 days ago or something like that. I'm not sure. I'm gonna hop on maybe sometime this weekend. Maybe for like a match or two. We'll see. I'm always down for some AVP. I actually did look up some matches on Classic AVP 2000 or AVP Classic 2000, whatever they call it. I just call it Gold Edition. AVP Gold Edition. So I was looking for some players in that, but yeah, there's never anyone hosting anything, and when I do host, no one really joins, so it's a pretty dead game. So, you know. Whoa! So I hear there's a new Call of Duty coming out. I don't think I'll get that game. I still have Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2. I really miss Modern Warfare 3. The support streak system was really fun. Like, even if you died or lost a streak, you still build up rewards, which is pretty cool. But the good thing about that system was that they give you streaks that were not really based off offensive attributes. It was more like defensive or support based, which was good. And I love using the EMP. It just shut down everything, like the AC-130, the helicopters, the missile strikes and stuff like that. Like, EMP was like the best. And the funny thing is that they had EMP in Black Ops 2, but no one uses it. Like, everyone goes for the assault or the aggressive or the offensive based streaks. So I love the EMPs. And I love the hacking thing to hack their care packages. Or like to drop your own fake care package, and it's like an explosive device in disguise. That was in Modern Warfare 3. That was pretty cool. I believe in Black Ops 1 you could hack the enemy's care package and it turns into an explosive. I had a lot of fun with Black Ops 1. I still have it, but I just haven't gotten around to actually playing it that much in multiplayer to try to go for what is it, 15 prestige? Oh my god. I see this in like a couple of videos all the time too, because I want that 15 prestige animated emblem. It's so cool. It's a fun game, but the net code was just really bad. It was bad. Speaking of net code, some fighting games that are really old, like Mortal Kombat Arcade Collection. I hope they make that backwards compatible sometime in the future for Xbox One, because I really miss that game. They brought back King of Fighters 98, 2002, Neo Geo Battle Coliseum, Virtua Fighter, Virtual On, but I still want to play Mortal Kombat 9. Oh, they also brought back Ultra Street Fighter 4, which is cool. I also want to play Street Fighter Cross Tekken once again, but I do miss playing Mortal Kombat Arcade Collection. I love playing Mortal Kombat 2. I have like a huge playlist of just MK2 online matches. It was so fun. I liked it. Whoa, there goes the creeper. So, we're going to the harbor market, and there's Alma. There are screams. Nice, look at that. It's like ripping into like the fabric of space. Like, wow. Are they shooting missiles? Or no. Can't be missiles. I don't think so. I don't know what it was. That was weird. Huh. Alright, so anyways. Let me make my way over here. Whoa, something fell down. I just saw the creeper. Alright, let's go down here. Okay. I actually thought about buying that Dragon Ball FighterZ game when it gets released next year, but the fact that I still have not played the beta or the demo just really bothers me. Because it looks really fun. Who knows? Like, I might change my mind later on in 2018. We'll see. I mean, it looks fun, and I like DBZ. Like, the last one I played that I had a lot of fun with was Raging Blast 2, and that game was good. I also did play some older DBZ games. Like, there was one on the arcade, which I did do some videos on back in like 2009 or 2010. It was a very interesting type of DBZ fighting game, I'll say that. I can't remember exactly. Oh, it was called Dragon Ball, I think, VRVS or ZRZV or something like this. It was a weird name, okay? But the point here is that it was like a split screen vertical game that was like a one-on-one based game with two buttons and a joystick. It was really weird for a DBZ game in the arcade that way, but it actually worked out okay for it. I will try to put down a video of it, a link somewhere, so you guys can see it sometime. Anyways, or you can just like do a search on Dragon Ball, I think VRVS it's called, arcade. Something like that. So I did play the ones on the Super Famicom, which is basically the Japanese name of the Super Nintendo. But yeah, Dragon Ball Raging Blast 2 was my favorite out of all of them. I had a lot of fun with it. If that gets made backwards compatible, I'll be happy. It's cool because they also made Black backwards compatible, which is an Xbox original game. So if they're making those games backwards compatible, then maybe in the future I'll get Predator: Concrete Jungle backwards compatible on Xbox One. That will be cool because I want to play that game again, but at the same time, I don't want to buy a 360 just for that game. I don't want to do it. I really don't want to. Like, I just want to have one console, and that's it. This dude moves a lot, this face caster. I don't think his suit is animated. Wait, is it? I think it is. Well, aside from when you actually hit him with a bullet. Where are you? He's got that laser gun. I gotta heal first. Oh, there was also another fear game. What was it called? Oh geez, I did a small review on it, like I think two or 3 years ago, a long time ago. I forgot what it was called. It was like a mix of Fear 2 and Fear 3. I think it was called Fear Online or something. I forget what it was called, man. I gotta look it up. It's just right now, off the top of my head, I cannot remember what the name was, but it was something like that. It was a combination of Fear 2 and Fear 3, and they had like a game mode with I think a four-player co-op in like the sewers or the subway system. Oh man. And I tried the multiplayer, but one thing I noticed about the multiplayer in that game was that it felt like Counter-Strike, not like Fear. And that was my main complaint about that version of Fear. It was weird. Anyways, so we have this robot here. I gotta use these EMP grenades to stun him. I don't think this rifle is doing a lot of damage. So, what I'm gonna do is cut this video here because this is pretty long so far, and we'll continue in the next video. So that's it for now. Stay tuned for the next video where I get to finish off this damn robot. So I will see you guys next time.